Graph, f of x equals negative 2 to the x. First, let's take a look at what graphs in general, graphs of exponential functions, look like. So if we have this coordinate plane, and you have something like y equals a times b to the x. Now remember, this exponent of x is only being applied to this factor of b. The graph is going to look like this. That's when a is positive. So if x is 0, well, anything raised to the 0 power is just 1. So that would make this part equal to 1. And 1 times a then would just be a. So this point is at 0, a. Okay, so it crosses this y-axis when y equals a. And then it can go up steeply. It can also drop down. I'm going to look at that in the next example. But now what if this, if we've got a negative? This is really, let's rewrite this. This negative 2 to the x. If this were in parentheses here, the story would be different. But right, the way it is written, it's like saying negative 1 times 2 to the x. So in this case, our a is negative. And if a is negative, we said that when x is 0, the graph is going to cross the y-axis at a. Right, so I'm going to write right here. This is our a right there. So it's going to come down like this. It's still crossing at y equals a, but in this case, a is negative 1. Now, of course, you could always, for any function in the world, you could just plot points and make a graph. You wouldn't have to get a feel for what an exponential graph looks like. But I'm just giving a rough idea or a general idea of what the rough graphs look like. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to make it formal and put it over here. We've got this crossing the y-axis when y is negative 1, and it's going to go down like this. You can always plot points and get exactly where those points are, but this is a rough sketch. Now, let's look at why this is. How about this? If this is a graph of b to the x, or more generally, or more specifically, 2 to the x, and we're just saying the opposite of that, then whatever you think you have, you actually have the opposite of it. So all along this graph, so when you have a negative, you can think of it as a negative multiplier, it's going to just flip this over. That's the mathematical term, is reflection about the x-axis, and that's what's happening here. Okay, let's talk about the other example, graph g of x equals 3 to the negative x. I'm just going to say right away that equals 1 over 3 to the positive x. And that is when our base is something between 0 and 1. When our base is something between 0 and 1, well, it's still going to cross the x-axis at 1, or the multiplier times this. This has a multiplier of just 1. So you could write this as equals 1 times 1/3 to the x, right, in that form of a times b to the x. Okay, so it's still going to cross there at a, cross the y-axis. However, let's think about what happens. You can always plot points, but what if x gets really big? Well, you've got 1/3 times 1/3 times 1/3 times 1/3. What if x was 10? 1/3 raised to the 10th power. That's a really small number, right? So it's actually, what's going to happen here is this graph is going to come down. It's going to be in that shape. It's never going to go negative, because you can never make this quantity be something negative. But it will look like this. Okay, so in general, you have this. This will be our form in general. And I'll say when b is in between 0 and 1, where in this case our 1/3 is our b. Okay, so we've graphed a couple of exponential functions.